This week, I tried designing and coding grainy textures every day, tackling grainy gradients, grainy background textures, and grainy neuromorphic styles, hover effects, and so on. There are two sides to this story, the designing process and the coding f***ery. So let's just start from the very beginning. I've always seen grainy textures used in beautiful designs everywhere, and I still kept avoiding it for some reason. Until recently, I made the CodePen texture challenge an excuse to actually take my shot at it. Grainy textures are a form of image noise characterized by visible patterns of randomly distributed dots or grains. This was originally caused by high ISO settings on old cameras or low light conditions when taking a picture. There are other types of noise as well, like Gaussian noise, salt and pepper noise, and so on. You might also see some newer types of noise created mathematically and digitally, like Perlin noise, Voronoi noise, and cellular noise. Here, we'll just be recreating grainy film noise from modern UI because it looks super aesthetic. The first part is the design. Let's say you're going to do it on Figma for UI design like I did. You could just download a noise texture PNG off the internet and call it a day. Or you could use the amazing free plugins on Figma. There are so many different plugins, and after trying out just a couple of them, I set up with this one, Noise and Texture. This plugin allows you to fiddle with the settings and make whatever type of noise you want. Ultimately, we want to make it grainy, so we'll fiddle around with the first one. Every one of these settings can affect the way your grainy texture will look like. For example, I can just change nothing, and it will come out looking like white noise. But if we were to recreate these grainy designs I found on Dribbble, we would have to do a lot more than that. For the first one, I'm adding a gradient in the background and placing the simple white noise texture on top of it, maxing the exposure and contrast, adding some opacity, and that's it. For the second one, I'm adding a gradient to the circle, which is supposed to be a cloud, and then I'm adding a noise layer, maxing the exposure and contrast, duplicating the gradient layer, moving it all the way to the top, adding opacity to one side of the gradient, and then we have recreated kind of the same effect.
You should keep in mind that this was probably created using an Illustrator app like Procreate or Adobe Illustrator, but we're trying to recreate it in Figma.
For the last one, I'm just creating a rectangle on top, adding my normal noise layer to it, decreasing the opacity, selecting the circles, adding layer blur so they'll be all blurry and cool, and there we go. The truth is that, just like the designs I made this week, you'll mostly just be dealing with basic noise settings and opacity. Now, let's move on to the good part, the code. There are four ways you can go about it. Import a PNG file with a texture, import an external SVG file in CSS, import the SVG in CSS using Base64, which is basically encoded SVG, and finally just add the SVG as extra markup. There are some downsides to each of these. For example, the PNG's quality is, let's just say, bad. The external SVG file does not allow you to edit the SVG itself if you need to. Same with Base64, plus there are some browser support issues. And lastly, with the extra markup, it just takes a bit of HTML space and you'd have to use extra CSS to make sure it works properly. The PNG obviously has to go out. Step 1. Create the SVG. You can either use a tool to create it or just write it yourself. There are several great tools out there. I found this specific one very useful. It allows you to fiddle with the settings and either copy the SVG code or download it and then upload it wherever you want. But if you want to write it yourself, here's how to do it. Start with the SVG tag and then a filter tag inside it so we can create the texture with it. Inside the filter tag, we'll add an FE turbulence tag, which is where the main settings of the noise will be saved. The first basic setting is type, which could be fractal noise or turbulence. Then we'll add a base frequency, which can be any number really. The higher it is, our grains will be smaller and closer to our main goal. Now we have this basic SVG code and we want to use it. First, let's add an ID to the filter so we can identify it, and then in CSS, we can add a filter to the container and target the filter ID. Simple as that. I gotta admit though, this is like the most basic SVG you could create. Instead, you can add a shape to it, like a rectangle, circle, or just a random shape. Creating a shape in SVG is too much hassle, so my pro tip personally is to go to Figma, create any shape you want, and export it as SVG. Open it in a browser, check inspect element, and just copy the path. Then paste the path right underneath the filter, and instead of adding the filter in CSS, just add it in the shape markup. Step 2. Import the SVG. So now we have a cool little grainy SVG. We could upload it somewhere and import in the code using CSS. Or we could turn it into Base64 and import it using CSS. Once again, for doing this, there are lots of tools out there, and I found this specific one helpful because it's simple. With this tool, just paste the SVG code or upload it and grab the string URL as soon as it's ready. Then just add this string URL to the background of the container. The third way is just to add it into the HTML markup. Just let it sit there on its own. We'll figure out what to do with it later. Step 3. Give yourself a pat on the back. The hard part is over, and now all you have to do is find a design you like, style it, add animations, effects, whatever you like. It's really simple. Alright, but seriously, if you want to get the most basic use out of the grainy texture you just made, you can add it to the body section of your website using pseudo elements. Now, whatever else you want to put on that page will just go underneath this grainy overlay and make it look cool. These three designs implement the same exact method. I think there is so much we can do with grainy textures in code. For example, we can add a gradient over the grainy texture and create some kind of grainy gradient, or as they call it, gradient. We could also increase the contrast or the brightness of the filter and make the grains stand out, which is exactly what I've done in this specific design. Mixing SVGs with CSS can lead to so many different possibilities, and the limit is your imagination. And that's all for this video. If you liked it, make sure you do your magic down there. Let me know what you want me to explore next, and see you on the next one.